Read me the entire sentence.
Today is Friday, May 12th.
Beautiful. Now, can you say it in Spanish?
Señor Tovar, hoy es viernes, mayo 12.
Language is tied to identity. You don't have to give up your identity of who you are in order to learn English. So because we value the whole student, our newcomers are becoming confident learners. ¿Lo puedes decir en Zapoteco?
Voy a intentarlo.
I love that attitude. Here in Selma, we're very diverse, and we've been seeing an influx of newcomer students, ranging from anywhere from Yemen to Guatemala, India, and other countries. Typically, anywhere from 5 to 8 languages are represented in my classroom. And so that brings many challenges. It's really important for me to know what their heritage language is, which allows me to assess whether or not they're proficient in their primary language. What? How do we say what in Zapotec? Guanli. How do we say what in Arabi?
He is very familiar with us. That's why we feel so confident here.
The whole purpose of allowing students to tap into their heritage language is for them to practice their speaking skills. If you can't say it in your primary language, you'll have a difficulty saying it in your secondary language. I would tell them, do it again. Take 2, take 3. Say it again.
¿Cómo deletreas hoy?
If he asks us about English word, he say, Simran, what do you say in Punjabi?
So part of language development is ensuring that our students have ample time and ample opportunities to speak. The goal is for them to be able to be proficient in both languages.
Yes.
Translanguaging, right? Being able to flow from one language to another or interchangeably using both languages.
Fernando is triste. Y hablo español and I learn English in my third hour class.
Class, are you ready?
Yes.
Every student in my classroom has a home team. That's the team that they're with for the entire year. Students need to be able to learn how to collaborate.
What is this?
They all have a role. Some are really talented with technology, so I place those under the CTO position, the Chief Technology Officer. So rather than students coming to me, they actually go to the CTO first. And then the CEO, I use team captain. They also in charge of helping each other within the team.
I am captain of my team, so I help my friends to my team. I know how to learn and how to teach other guys.
Especially in junior high, they are concerned about what their peers think of them and how they're gonna come across. So that's why whenever we can, celebrate failure, applaud when they fail. You can change your mind. Give her a hand for failing. That creates this type of atmosphere where it's okay to take risks. Why is it okay to fail in class, Abraham?
It's fine to fail in class because you are here to learn.
So Simran, try again.
We move forward 4 times.
We know and research says that students that are reclassified, which means that they've met the criteria to no longer be called an English language learner, they actually outperform monolinguals.
Mr. Tovar, my favorite food is pizza.
Anytime we can encourage them to develop their heritage language so that it's in par with their English or vice versa, the ultimate goal really is to be bilingual and biliterate so that you'll be able to be not only a contributing citizen, but also to be a bridge maker when you speak multiple languages with multiple communities.